Good evening, everyone. Let us now see the design of a half-wave dipole antenna. As the name suggests, half-wave, it means that the antenna possesses an electrical length of lambda by 2 at its frequency of operation. So we know that the wavelength is represented by the term lambda, and the half-wave dipole antenna possesses an electrical length of lambda by 2. Hence, the name half-wave dipole. So if you see here, there are two conductors which are present. So this will be at a length of lambda by 4, this will be at a length of lambda by 4, and the total length is lambda by 2. And hence, we call this to be a half-wave dipole antenna. We would have studied the theory of the half-wave dipole in the previous video. Now we are going to see the design of a half-wave dipole antenna. The main reason why half-wave dipole design is very useful is that the half-wave dipole possesses a radiation resistance of 73 ohms, which is almost equal to the resistance of the transmission line, which is 75 ohms. And we know that only when the impedance of the transmission line and the antenna are properly matched, we can say that the maximum power gets transferred. Since transmission line has an impedance of 75 ohms, and the half-wave dipole has an impedance of 73 ohms, achieving impedance matching between the transmission line and the antenna is very easy. And hence, the half-wave dipole is a very prevalent design of antenna. Coming to the design of half-wave dipole antenna, we are mainly going to find out the field components of the antenna, which are the electrical fields and magnetic fields. After finding the electrical fields and magnetic fields, we will calculate the average power due to the antenna, and using the average power, we will calculate the radiation resistance. So we will prove that the half-wave dipole has an impedance of 73 ohms at the end of this derivation. Now, starting with the design of a half-wave dipole, we can see this diagram that is present here. This is the half-wave dipole antenna, and let us consider this half-wave dipole is fed by a transmission line, which means a source is provided to the antenna by the transmission line. And this dipole has a total length of 2h. In this axis, it is length of minus h to 0, and from here it is 0 to h. So the total length of the antenna is 2h. This is your physical length of the antenna. Next, I'm going to consider a distant point P at which we are measuring the fields of the antenna. So let us consider that this point P is at a distance of small r from this origin point, and a distance of capital R from the small element which we are considering in the antenna. So it is not possible to consider the total antenna and proceed with the design. We will consider a small element or a small part of the antenna dz, and let us assume that this current element dz is present at a distance of capital R from the distant point P. So this point P is at a distance of small r from the origin point, and a distance of capital R from the current element that we are considering for the measurement purpose. And we already saw in the explanation part that the current is sinusoidal in nature. At the two ends, the currents are zero, and at the center, the current reaches the maximum. So this current takes up a sinusoidal nature. If you observe the value of the current that is flowing through this antenna, it is Im sin beta h plus h and Im sin beta h minus z. Im is the maximum current of this current element. Sin is because it takes up a sinusoidal form. Beta is your phase shift constant, which signifies the movement of waves. So we already studied in the subject of transmission lines that only if a phase shift is there, it signifies the propagation of waves. So this term beta signifies the phase shift constant. And h plus z represents the minus h axis, and h minus z signifies the positive axis. So currents are represented as Im sin beta h plus z in the negative scale and Im sin beta h minus z in the positive scale. Now let us start with the design of the half-wave dipole. So as I said earlier, we are going to find the fields of the half-wave dipole antenna. but it is not directly possible to evaluate the fields that is radiating. That design is too complicated. So if we want to find the electric and magnetic field of the antenna, we usually start from the source of the radiation. Then we will find the vector magnetic potential due to this radiation. And finally, we will calculate the required field components. Because directly analyzing the field is not possible, we have to start from the source of the radiation, which is nothing but the current element that is present here. So we will start from the current element. Using the current element, we will find the vector magnetic potential. And using the vector magnetic potential, we are going to calculate the field components. This is the flow that we are going to go through this derivation. Now let us start deriving. So we have written two values here, small r and capital R, signifying the distances of the point P. So let us consider the triangle ABC that is present here. In triangle ABC, we can write this distance AC. If you see here, this is a triangle ABC. Now what will be this distance AC? This total distance is small r. From the total distance of small r, if I remove this part, what I'll get is the remaining balance part. So AC is nothing but it is small r minus capital R. Small r is the total distance. Capital R is the distance of the point P from this current element. So AC can be obtained by the total length minus, if I subtract this length, what I'll be obtaining is this AC value. Now we know that cos theta is equal to adjacent side divided by hypotenuse. So if you observe the triangle that is present here, the adjacent side is nothing but it is AC and the hypotenuse is nothing but it is AB. So this is nothing but AC is R minus R divided by AB is Z, and therefore from this we'll be getting Z cos theta is equal to R minus R, or we can write capital R is equal to, or in other words, we can write capital R is equal to R minus Z cos theta. So this is how we have written capital R is equal to small r minus Z cos theta. I hope this part is clear to you all.